I snatched Will Graham right out of your mouth. You must be famished.
There is an inescapable parallel between you and Jezebel, Mason. Keen Bible student that you are, you'll recall dogs ate Jezebel's face, along with the rest of her.
Jezebel was right with the risen Jesus. The Riz would have provided her with a new face, as he has provided mine. The transplant surgery is extremely skillful, which is why Cordell here will be performing the face-off.
Hello.
You boys remind me of that German cannibal who advertised for a friend and then ate him and his penis before he died. Tragedy being, the penis was overcooked. You go to all that trouble to eat a friend and you overcook his penis. I ate it anyway. They had to. They committed. But they didn't enjoy it. I'm committed to enjoying every bite of you.
You're going to eat him with my face?
Yeah. I got a taste for it after you two have me eat my nose.
You must be terribly proud that you could bring this off. It's dangerous to get exactly what you want. What will you do after you've eaten me?
You could wreck some foster homes and torment some children.
Oh, drink martinis made with tea.
But where, Mason, would the hardcore fun come from?
It's foolish to dilute such an ecstatic time as this with fears about the future. Cordell, Mr. Graham's looking very dry. A little moisturizing, please.
I'm curious, what will be the first cuts of me in the show?
The first course, of course, will be your hands and feet. Sizzling on a Promethean barbecue. The coal is white and very hard. It makes a clear ringing sound when struck.
You've thought of everything.
And after that, we'll have a little pajama party, okay? You can be in shorts by then. Huh? Cordell is gonna keep you alive for a very long time. Well, no pajama party for you, Mr. Graham.